Morning class.
Good morning, ma'am.
Today we are going to perform an experiment, and the aim of that experiment is, you can see here, to determine the density of a solid. We have to take a solid which is denser than water by using a spring balance and this measuring cylinder. Okay? What are the apparatus required for this experiment? One spring balance is there. This is called retort stand with clamp head and boss head. Okay, then we need measuring cylinder, and we need some objects, some weights which will be denser than water, so that we can immerse that object in that liquid and see the difference and calculate the density of that mass. Then we are going to see the theory regarding this is that you all know density is equal to mass per unit volume. We calculate mass here, we calculate volume. Density is represented by rho. It is known as RHO rho, which is equal to mass per unit volume. Now, what is the principle behind this experiment? Archimedes' principle. Whenever an object is partially or wholly immersed in a liquid, it displaces equal volume, equal to its weight volume, the liquid. And then we can calculate the volume. We can see here, volume of solid will be calculated at last. So you can see, first of all, we are going to see the initial reading of the water level in measuring cylinder. When we will immerse the object in that liquid, of course, the level of water will rise up due to Archimedes' principle, and upthrust force will be acting in it. So here it is V1, that is initial level of water. Then it will be V2, the final level of water. So I level should be kept at, you know, just at the front. After that we have observations. First thing to calculate or to use some equipment is that we should know the least count of that instrument. Which instrument we are using here?
Spring balance.
I told you earlier also. This spring balance, you know, will be calculated, and then you will be able to know the zero error of spring balance. What is zero error? This pointer should lie at zero. All spring balances, they must be at zero, only then you can start your calculation. Otherwise, if some error is there, that error is calculated, like is it positive error or is it negative error, and accordingly we add or subtract it. In this case, you can see zero error for this is zero. Zero is there?
Yes.
You can see pointer is lying at zero. After that, least count. How to calculate least count? Least count is the least measurement which we can measure from an object, from this instrument. So least count is range upon number of divisions. You can see here, the range of the spring balance which I am holding here is 0 to 1. So how will you calculate range? Initial is 0, final one is 1. Is there a range? So 1 minus 0. 1 minus 0. Here I am having this spring balance, it is having 0 to 2. So 2 minus 0 upon the number of divisions. Both spring balances have different least count. Okay? So 2 minus 0 upon number of divisions, we calculate it here as 0.2 Newton. Or we can take it in gram also. This side it is in gram also. Then observation table, you can see serial number, initial reading. First of all, we will see initial reading. It's at 0, the initial reading will be 0. Then we will hang some object here, then we will see the final reading, and then we will calculate by subtracting W2 minus W1. It will be the weight of that block. And then we will immerse our object in this liquid. Right now, the least count of this measuring cylinder is, can you see? What is the least count?
420.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, 50 upon number of divisions. How many divisions? 10. So, it's in ml. Okay? Now, let us start the experiment. First of all, we will hang this spring balance and we will calculate the weight. Initial it's 0 and final. Note down the reading. Can you tell me, Harshika, the readings?
4 Newton and 400 gram.
Okay. 400 gram or 4 Newton. When will be the maximum loss in weight? So now the object is partially immersed. Can you see the loss in weight?
Yes, ma'am.
Pointer is going up.
Yes, ma'am.
I have dipped it now fully and it's fully immersed in the water. Pointer goes up.
Yes, ma'am.
And again you can see maximum loss in weight occurs when the object is fully immersed in water, in that liquid. Okay, so this is the buoyant force. Cylinder, it's at
400
m. After that, we are going to immerse this object in this and the level of water rises up. What is the final reading now?
480.
Which principle you learned from here? Archimedes principle. Liquid is giving some upward force also here, that is buoyant force. And level rises up. After calculating the difference in the two levels, final level minus initial level, we get our volume of solid. And in this way you will calculate mass per unit volume, that is density. Thank you.